think killed the dinosaurs? A comet? A volcano? What about dark matter? Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. Over 65.5 million years ago, a comet slammed into Earth, sending a giant death plume of debris into the atmosphere, killing almost all life on Earth, including most of the dinosaurs. We figured this one out. We've got the evidence, a huge crater in the middle of Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula. But what set that comet hurtling to Earth in the first place? Well, some geophysicists like Michael Rampino from New York University noticed something strange in the fossil record. They found that every 30 million years or so, there seemed to be a mass extinction. Some of these were smaller extinctions, but most of the big five mass extinctions match up with this timeline. So what could be working like clockwork to trigger a great loss of life on this planet? Well, some scientists like Rampino have an idea. They point the finger at dark matter. Yep, that strange mass of something out there that we can't see but only detect through its gravitational effects on objects around it. Some estimates say as much as 85% of all the stuff out there in the universe is actually dark matter. Theoretical physicist Lisa Randall suggests in her new book, Dark Matter and the Dinosaurs, that dark matter might be responsible for sending comets to Earth. So there might be dark matter concentrating in the center of our galaxy, the Milky Way, and it forms a kind of thin cloud. Randall suggests that maybe it's more of a disk made up of particles 100 times larger than a photon. The disk might be thin and dense. As our solar system moves through the disk, it bobs up and down like an apple in a barrel full of water. And those bobs are pretty regular, about every 30 million years or so. Because the disk is so dense, the gravitational tug would affect planetary bodies in our own solar system. It could even knock comets loose from their orbit in the Oort cloud, a cloud of dust and comets, and might send them towards Earth. And maybe this was the case for the rogue body that slammed into Earth 65.5 million years ago. But it's not just rogue comets this dark matter cloud could trigger, it could also trigger volcanoes! That's what Rampino suggested in an article published in the journal Monthly Notices of the Royal Astronomical Society. He claims that the dark matter particles gather in clumps in the disk, and those clumps get swept up by the Earth as it passes through the disk. These particles collect in the center of the Earth, where they reach sufficient densities to annihilate each other, which produces enormous amounts of heat. This heats up the Earth's core by a few hundred degrees, which expands the molten lava, putting pressure on the crust until it erupts in huge volcanic eruptions, maybe huge enough to wipe out most of life on this planet. Though I should caution, these ideas are still speculative at this point. There's still not a lot of evidence for a disk of dark matter in the center of our galaxy. There's some evidence that our nearest neighboring galaxy, Andromeda, might have one. And evidence of our own is yet to come. The European Space Agency's Gaia mission could reveal more about dark matter. The mission will track movements of hundreds of thousands of stars throughout the Milky Way, through which we could learn more about the distribution of dark matter. Till then, other scientists like Corin Baylor-Jones, an astrophysicist at the Max Planck Institute for Astronomy, told Scientific American that they remain skeptical about such a hypothesis. Some claim that the evidence is scarce for a clumpy dark matter disk, and others like Baylor-Jones even question the periodic nature of mass extinctions. So while it's a very cool hypothesis, I mean, who doesn't love dark matter, dinosaurs, and volcanoes in one hypothesis? I'd say more research is needed. You know what else is really cool together? Cloning and dinosaurs. Recently, we discovered actual fossilized dinosaur eggs. Does this mean we're closer to cloning a dinosaur and starting an awesomely terrifying theme park? Check out this video to learn more.
A fossil is sort of like a shadow or a model of a living organism made from rock. The most common fossil type for dinosaurs and their eggs is called permineralization, widely known as petrification.
Speaking of mass extinctions, if you like the shirt I have on and want to check out other DNews shirts, be sure to go to the link down below. We have a ton of cool science shirts for your buying pleasure. And if you're a first-time buyer, use the promo code DNews for 10% off at checkout. So what do you think about all this? Awesome hypothesis or a little out there? Debate down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons so you don't miss a single DNews episode.